Hello everyone, welcome to my channel for nursing exams learning. So today we will study endocarditis. So what do you mean by endocarditis? This is an inflammation of the inner layer of the heart and valves. And how does it happen? Through bacteria like Staphylococcus aureus if it is an acute endocarditis, and Streptococcus viridans if it is a chronic endocarditis. So this is a simple thing that you keep in your mind. Inflammation of the inner lining of the heart and walls, that is called endocarditis. Previous videos we studied pericarditis and myocarditis. So endocarditis, so this will be the three disease conditions will come under the heading of inflammatory heart diseases. Okay, you might have expect some questions from this area, that's why we are discussing all these three conditions. Now we'll see what are the clinical features of endocarditis. The client will be have a fever, then positive blood culture, it might be Staphylococcus aureus or it might be strep viridians. Then some of the classic features that you can see a client who is diagnosed with the endocarditis. The first one in the picture here, you can see Osler's knot. In the fingers, this area, you can feel that one, Osler's knot. Then another one, that is splinter hemorrhage. When you will see in the nails, in the picture, you can see there is like a slight blood spots just behind the nails plate. So splinter hemorrhage. Then another one is that janvulation. Then another one, rod spots. So these are some of the classic clinical features of endocarditis. Please keep these photos in your mind so you will remember that one. When you are practicing questions, please see whether if you will see these symptoms. Okay, these are some of the common expected symptoms of endocarditis. Then what are the interventions that usually for providing for a client who is diagnosed with endocarditis? Prevention, prevent venous stasis, periods of rest and activity. Then maintain anti-embolics and stockings as prescribed. Then IV therapy, antibiotics for 6 weeks. Then monitor cardiovascular status. When we are providing this, when the client is on antibiotic therapy, we should instruct the client about some of the side effects of some antibiotics. And health teaching also very important. Then monitor cardiovascular status. Then monitor for signs of emboli throughout the body. So these are some of the common interventions related to the endocarditis. Then what are the health teaching that the nurse should instruct to the client? Encourage the client to take rest periods as needed. Then wash hands to prevent infection. Because the infection, that is the leading cause of endocarditis. So the hand hygiene is very important. Then avoid crowded areas to reduce the risk of infection. Then participate in smoking cessation. Then educate the client to demonstrate the administration of intravenous antibiotics and management before discharge. That's what we said before. If the client is on antibiotic, should instruct the client should complete the course of the antibiotic and how does it work, what are the side effects and how to perform. Everything should be teach the client, and the client should require the enough knowledge upon discharge. Then educate the client about the importance of taking medications as prescribed. We already said medication compliance is very important. Then educate the client and family about the illness and encourage them to express their feelings. Then gentle, thorough oral care, vigorous brushing can lead to enter blood through gum. And another one main pointing that the client need prophylactic antibiotics before invasive procedures or before any dental procedures. Some of the questions are coming related to this point aspect. So that is also very important. If the client is going to undergo for any invasive procedures or dental procedures, the client should have take an antibiotic, prophylactic antibiotic before the particular procedure. So these are the main points related with endocarditis. Now we have studied what is endocarditis and what are the assessment features and what are the common interventions or medication management and health teaching. Health teaching is very important. I have included most of the points and the prophylactic antibiotic therapy for before invasive procedures. Just keep in your mind. So we'll conclude the topic here. In the next video, most probably we'll discuss one or two questions related to endocarditis. Bye for now. Take care and study well.